Good evening, everyone. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe. It has been a ferociously windy day. Take a look at some of these top wind gusts across the state. Guilford, 53-mile-per-hour wind gusts earlier in the day. Meredith, 52 miles per hour. Near 50 miles per hour in Ringe. Laconia, Concord had wind gusts near 45 miles per hour. And this wind has brought down tree limbs, power lines. There's lots of tree debris all over the roads. Be careful of that if you're traveling this evening. The wind speeds, they still are strong. Now, this is the sustained wind. Look at Plymouth. That's not even a gust. Sustained at 21 miles per hour. Some wind gusts still up near 30 miles per hour in a lot of spots, and that will be the case as we get into the early part of the evening and overnight. Finally, once we arrive at about midnight, you see here, that's the time stamp, that most of us begin to see the winds really diminishing some. You're going to hear it as you're going to bed tonight, but as we get into the early morning hours tomorrow, it really will diminish. Now, tomorrow, we still will have the breeze kicking up, though certainly not the 50 mile per hour wind gusts, but there could be some gusts approaching maybe 15 to 20 miles per hour. So because the winds are still pretty active, we have a wind advisory that goes until midnight tonight now, and some of these places in the brown, really across the state, could have wind gusts exceeding 30 miles per hour up until midnight tonight. The reason it's been so mild, we're in a boundary between warm air and cold air, and the cold air is winning out. Over the next couple of days, we'll have below average temperatures. In fact, Saturday, look at that, highs only in the teens and 20s, but it's a short break with the cold. We'll start to move back up into the 40s, maybe even 50s by midweek next week. Not much happening on the satellite and radar. Earlier, we had a few snow showers in the North Country and even the Lakes region. Those are gone. So with the clear skies overnight and the winds diminishing a bit some too, it's going to be cold. But behind this system that's moving out, we have actually some clear skies, so we're going to be storm free for a while here. Here's futurecast. Through the overnight hours tonight, temperatures drop into the single digits up north. Teens from Laconia to Concord, 20s when you wake up tomorrow morning, Manchester and toward the seacoast. Throughout the day tomorrow, the breeze active, but not quite as strong as what we saw today. Teens and 20s for highs, a few 30s into Concord, Manchester and Nashua. Now in the evening time tomorrow, there could be a few scattered snow showers or flurries, especially in the Monadnock region and into southern New Hampshire, the North Country too, not amounting to anything, but you might see a few flurries falling at that time. Saturday, dry, sunny, but ooh, it's going to be cold. Take a look at these temperatures. Teens and 20s for highs on Saturday, and the wind will still be active, so it will feel brisk. Sunny on Sunday, same thing on Monday, and then some showers move in as we get into Tuesday and Wednesday of next week.